What is up, YouTube? Wow. So today I'm actually gonna put up my first video on YouTube. So I have a few videos out, but like it's completely garbage, and I haven't like put my face on it. I just felt like, you know, I've wanted to do YouTube for a long time, so I don't see why I can't start now. So this is basically just going to be a video on like. Basically like my build or my future build and plans that I want to do on the car and things like that. This is my first car. I'm fortunate enough to have this car as my first car, so I am really blessed that I can have this car for my first car. It's gonna be like for me to go to college and back, things like that. So yeah, I want to study motor mechanics. So that is obviously in the year, then I should start eventually with college. But for now, I feel like I've always wanted to do YouTube, and if I'm gonna start, I have to start now, because I wanted to do it for a long time. So I don't see why I don't start now, because I have nothing to do now at the moment. I'm just sitting at home basically doing nothing, so I felt like it's about time that I, well, go up on the net and do this that I've wanted to do for quite a while. So yes, I am. I'm 18 years old. I drive a 2007 Candy White Mark V GTI. The car has the 2-liter turbo, BWA engine, and DSG automatic transmission. I'll speak about the specs and everything on the car at another time. The car is stock, there's nothing done to the car. Yeah, the car is like never been tampered with. We got a good deal on the car. It came from a good area. I live in South Africa, so the car came in a good area. Came from a good area. The car has full service history, full books and all that stuff. DSG and engine services were always done on time. And as you know, these DSG gearboxes needs to be well maintained in order to keep them for a long time. The car that this one has quite a few things that I definitely wanted in a car, and we got this one, which was absolutely amazing. So the car as it is, it's candy white, so I wanted either a white Mark V or a red Mark V, and when I saw this one, I just definitely knew that I wanted this one. The car has a sunroof, which was a big must for me. DSG gearbox, another big must for me. I love the feel that of the pedal shifts and things like that. I feel like it gives you more of like a, you know, like a, you know, I'm not gonna now sound like an idiot but a supercar feel, because pedal shifts and that stuff, and also the response time on the pedals is actually really quick for 07. Like the DSG box back in the day was like good, and it's still being used. That just shows how good it is. Obviously there's been like, you know, improvements and things on the gearbox, but overall the gearbox is very, very good. Shift responses on the pedals and even on the lever itself, very, very fast. I love the sound also that the DSG creates by dropping a drop of fuel in exhaust, something like that, and creates a little fart, a burp. That's also really cool. I really like that. The 2-liter itself is also a very good engine. I believe they need like a lot of maintenance and stuff like that. But the car itself, we definitely looked long. I looked like 3-4 months for a good Mark V, because we wanted the one with at least a full service history, you know, one we can start from the ground up. We didn't want one that is modified, because we knew for a fact if we get one that is modified, it's definitely been driven hard. Obviously it's a GTI, any GTI basically in South Africa has been driven hard. I'm an example. If I had this GTI for a long time, I know I've been driving it hard. I know for this past 2 months I've been driving the car hard. The car isn't fast. Like a GTI is not slow also, it's not a slouch on the road. It has enough pickup to, you know, so you can, you know, when you can do anything. But you definitely have to make sure that you, whatever. So I'm just going to take you on a brief walk around on the car. So we can just have of what the car is like. In the 2 months that I had the car, I did do a few things to it. But I'll show you that on another video. For now, I'll just take you on a brief walk around of the car, and yeah, I'll get back to you. So here we go. So these headlights was actually replaced on the car. These are depot headlights. The car has a few small things on it, but I'm not going to speak about it now. I'll keep that for another video. As you can see, the car is candy white. There's a few things broken on the car also, but nothing major. Sunroof is tilted as always. Wheels definitely needs to be redone on the car. And I'll just, in another video, I'll show you guys the small things that I've done on the car so far in the 2 months of ownership that I do have on the car. The car is pretty neat, I have to say. Very good example of a Mark 5, but just definitely just the wheels that needs to be done. When you come to the engine bay, it's just also a little small thing that I've done. I don't know if it doesn't really do anything, but it does create a little bit more of a turbo sound. This isn't the proper intake for this car, but it definitely works. And this is, like, I saw it on a thread on Facebook where you can add like a filter to the front of it, and you take the filter inside of the box out, and it you know, it almost like it like that access the new filter. This access the new filter, and because there's nothing, no restrictions inside here, so it's acting like almost like the normal pipe and things like that. But I can do definitely say the car does give a more of a like a turbo sound off on acceleration and decel. The blow off is actually really good, and it's definitely noticeably louder than it was stock. Yeah, so definitely the wheels needs to be done 100%. Overall, honestly, the car is really good. On the interior of the car, definitely also a really good example. The car has very little wear on it, as DSG, and obviously there's a few things, just little things that it's missing, but overall, honestly, the condition of the seats and everything is really good on the car. I'm definitely happy with how the car looks. And yeah, like I said, we took 5 months 4 months to actually get a good one, and this one like literally stood out to us. Like, we needed, like, it's obvious wear and tear on the car, but like seriously, like, the car is in a really good nick. Understand, like, there isn't much wear and tear on the car, especially just the driver's side seat and things like that, you know, like small things. Let's go to the back. So the car is definitely in good condition. I'm missing a floor mat also. Yeah, and this boot liner definitely needs to be replaced. I have no clue what went on here. Don't know what the previous owner did. I removed myself. I took the spare wheel out. I felt like it's definitely not needed. Of course, I don't run flats, but I mean, I don't need a spare wheel like that donut. Like, seriously, I don't want you. Definitely going to put on run flat tires in the future. They give a harder ride, but I just feel safer with run flats, feeling for the tire bursts and things on high speed. I feel like they're more safer than normal tires. They can actually burst. Oh, I don't know if run flats can also burst or things like that, but yeah. So that's a quick overview of the car and how the car is looking. So honestly, I would say the car is in condition wise a good 7.5 out of 10 for 2007 model. The car is really in good condition. Really happy with how the interior, the exterior, all those things are on the car. Very good. Yeah, so I have a few plans. Obviously, I do not work at the current moment. I just finished matric. I'm waiting actually on my matric results now, so I don't have like a lot of money to do anything on the car. But there is a few things that I've done on the car, small things, like literally so subtle, and I will obviously show you guys in the next video all the stuff that I've done on the car, you know. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video. Yeah, thank you for watching. Peace.